Because I had weight loss surgery at age 49, I feel like my life started at 50. I remember saying, I feel like I've fallen in love with myself. And that feeling would have probably lasted forever if excess skin hadn't been one of the outcomes of my weight loss. I feel like the weight in some ways is still there because it's a constant reminder of what my body was. I was addicted to sweets, to sugar. Around 6 years old, I started putting on weight. When I was 11, my mother took me to a hypnotherapist, hoping that that might help. And one of the first things he told me was, you know, if you don't lose weight, you'll never find anybody to love you, and you'll never have a boyfriend. That made me feel incredibly hopeless and incredibly ugly. But it wasn't enough to curb my eating habits.
Renee's weight kind of skyrocketed as she was living in England after the birth of her children with her husband. And I think the stresses of living out of the country played a factor in the escalating of her weight.
It was a lot of eating out of loneliness. And after I had my children, I hit my highest weight of 406 pounds. I look back and I just see major depression. I think I was about 47, 48. When I had to have a stent put in my heart because I had coronary artery disease at that time. And so I finally decided to go see about gastric bypass. After the surgery, I lost 250 pounds over the course of about 18 months. And I kept the weight off for about 12 years. But because of health problems, I had to have a quadruple bypass surgery on my heart. And during that time, I just started putting on weight again because I was so inactive. I first noticed skin issues when my body just started looking deflated. As much work as I've done, I can't feel and see the firmness in any part of my body. There is a nice skinny person under there. You know, it's just a matter of finding her. My skin is definitely holding me back from pursuing all the things that I would love to do. All my life, I've always been an artist. And I became quite well known in the field of fashion doll makeovers. I started painting faces. I developed processes of making wings and attaching them. It was just a joy. This little girl has had ears sculpted and had ears attached. I enjoy talking to people about my dolls because it's an art that means a lot to me. But I find it uncomfortable to be in front of the public all day or out working and being uncomfortable with the way I look.
And when it comes to my social life, I feel the same discomfort.
Hey, babe, you ready?
Yeah, as ready as I'll ever be, I guess. When I'm out with Phil and we're going someplace outside or I know it's going to be hot, I'll wear something that I'm comfortable in. And of course, visually, I'm not. And it makes me feel self-conscious. It makes me feel older than I am. And I just feel like I really want to run away and hide sometimes.
It would mean everything to me to live out the rest of my life with the body that I feel like I was always meant to have.
I have come such a long way, and I'm 64 years old, and I feel great, but the skin is just still there. My only option is to have surgery. It's just time for it to be gone.
Coming this morning, and I'm headed into the hospital, going to get my surgery done. I can't believe it.
It's hard to even put words to it the way I feel. It's a little overwhelming right now.
You know, having come so far and then to be told I need to have the cardiac testing and it may cause me not to be able to proceed any further was hard. It was very hard. But
right now, I'm totally elated.
Good morning.
Oh.
How are you?
All right.
I understand we sent you over to the heart doctor. They did some tests, and so we're good to go this morning, okay?
Yes.
All right, my dear, well, let's draw some lines on you. Have you hop up out of bed?
I have lived in this skin all my life, and I feel like there's this person inside of this skin that just needs to get out.
Today we're gonna perform on Renee a lower body lift, and we're also gonna remove the excess skin of the side of her chest and her arms. Indicator's good. Okay, we are go for launch.
Renee is my anchor to my life. She's been through quite a bit over a number of years to get here today. My hopes for Renee, we'll just keep doing what we've been doing for another 1,500 years.
The second stage of Renee's surgery requires us to turn her over so we can access under her arms and tighten up the skin on the sides of her upper body. All right, let's get this abdomen started. In phase three, we'll remove the excess skin from Renee's stomach and pull down what's left behind to tighten everything up. Okay, things are looking good and we're done. Renee's gonna notice a big difference in the contour of her arms and the side of her chest. And of course, we also got a lot of skin off of the abdomen, hips, and waist. So I'm hoping she sees a lot of smoothing of those areas.
Hey, sleepy.
We've hit all Renee's problem areas except her breasts and inner thighs, but she's got some tough recovery ahead of her.
I did real good.
Mm-hmm. Yes, you did. You did real good.
It's been 3 months since I started this journey to have my skin removed. This process has been really tough, but it's been worth it. The hardest part was holding back from doing too much. So I'm very happy that I've decided not to go forward with my next surgery, but to be at my goal weight and to be happy with the way my body looks is just, it gives me goosebumps. I'm going to be able to visit with some friends and family this evening to show them what I've accomplished. And I couldn't be happier being any place but where I am right now. I see my body changing on a day-to-day basis. After so many years of dealing with the excess weight and then to being left with just a still deformed body, it's so nice to actually see the accomplishments that I've made. Tonight, we're finally going to be able to go out and show off my new body.
My mom looks so amazing. I'm so happy for her. This is what she's always wanted. And she looks the way I've always seen her to look, which is beautiful.
Renee looks absolutely stunning. I am so proud. It's been such a long journey, and she's done it. She's made it.
Everything came to me at a later point in my life, but here I am, and I'm like, well, hey, it may have taken you a long time to get here, but you're here. And when I catch myself in the mirror, it's just like, wow, that looks great. I look good. When I look at my arms now, I see curvature and muscle as opposed to deflated water balloons hanging from my arms.
It's hard to believe this is me. There's never been a time when I didn't have somewhat of a stomach and bulges here, and it's beyond anything I could imagine.
I love spending time with Phil, but I've always had this cloud of this excess skin hanging over me. Now, Phil and I are going to enjoy life to the fullest. And with the skin gone, whatever passion I want to pursue, I feel that this has just opened the door for all these wonderful things. Not having the skin has also had such a positive influence on how I'm able to spend time with my family. Now I can just get out there with my daughters and their kids with no hesitation.
I see in my mom someone who's happy with where her life is going, and she really deserves it. She really does.
I've been waiting 64 years to feel at home in my body, and I know it's only going to get better from here.